Hello, lovelies, and welcome back to my channel. Today we have a lot to go over. This is going to be a training time slash buying a new horse video. I have a lot to go over with you guys. There may be some lag because I am downloading a game onto my computer. I'm downloading Sims because I miss Sims and I want to play it again as a de-stressor. But I really wanted to go buy, I think I have Tellina. I wanted to buy the Campos that's still here. And yes, I did do an open house video, but I decided not to upload it because I was in a really bad place that day. So we're going to get more into that in a little bit. So Tellina and Campos are over this way. Yeah, over here. And they came back for a couple weeks. I already have the manta rays, but I don't, it's Tellina I haven't bought. But I don't have Tellina, so I'm going to go ahead and buy Tellina. I wanted to name Tellina Pearl something. Just Pearl, maybe? Is Pearl an option over here? Yeah. Pearl something. I don't know. Pearl Ocean? I don't know. Pearl Shore. Is Shore an option? We're gonna go all the way down. But yeah, there's been a lot going on, so there's a lot to go over. And I'm sure that you guys have missed me. I've missed you guys. Ah, Pearl Shore. We're gonna name it Pearl Shore. Yay! And we're gonna start the training time video right now, but I'm gonna probably go back to my home stable and start there because I like to do my training times in certain orders. So we're gonna go ahead and go back. So a little bit of an update on my life. I was working at a convenience place, like a Walmart type situation, grocery type situation, for a little bit, and then I have worked there all summer. I went on student leave. I was planning on working. I start law school in August. Classes start the 16th or the 17th, and I am planning on I have a lot going on that I haven't talked to you guys about. I'm trying to like get my brain to work. But I basically have an apartment. I'm rooming with three other law students that are all female, and I have a new kitten. His name is Viscount, and he's coming with me, and Nathan's going to take, Prince. My boyfriend is going to take Prince, with him while he goes back to school, and we're going to be about 3.5 hours from each other. I'm gonna miss him a lot. And I am getting ready to go to school, and it's just been a really crazy time. I went on student leave. We're going on student leave real soon. By the time you guys see this video, I already probably will be on student leave from work. I am planning on working in December, but I don't really think I'm gonna be working this first semester because I have to focus on law school and everything that comes with that. And something that they did that I don't, wow, I'm gonna have to start over this race. This is gonna be so depressing if I had to start over this race. I have to start over the race! Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. Yeah, now we're just gonna start the video here. I was like, I cannot believe I missed that jump. But basically, I just have a lot going on, and I mean, I spent like $1,000 on law school books. I had to take out some extra like federal loans to pay for everything. I have enough for my rent. I just don't have enough to live. And so I'm not going to be working the first semester, but we may have to change that depending on how things go. What does that mean for me and SSO? I'll be honest with you, SSO is starting to really bore me again. I really, really liked SSO when I was doing the dressage and everything, but as you can see right now, I am not in Pink Queen's Legacy. I'm still a member of the club. I just some things happened. I went from being like staff and like being a PL commander course and being on comp team to like starting the online course for my schooling, and I kind of had to make some decisions, and some of those decisions weren't easy to make, and it didn't go over well with me. The club was very understanding, but there was a lot of miscommunication, and so we're just kind of seeing how things are gonna go. I put myself on extended leave for a while. I was removed from the club, but then I came back because they asked me if I could go on extended leave, and we'll see how things go and what happens. I have to go to a practice to be able to get back in the club, like actually in the club. I'm in the Discord right now, but I'm not in the club. But I'm no longer on staff. There was just some things that didn't go over well, and some things that my cat is on my face and I can't see the screen anymore. Oh gosh. Move. Okay, late. No. He thinks when I'm on the computer that that means that he can like be wherever he like right on top of me, which would be fine if I didn't need to see my computer screen. But there was just a lot going on there, and they've been as gracious as they can be, and as understanding as they can be. But I also understand that like they have stuff that they need to do within the club, and if I can't do that, it's not really their fault, not really mine either, to be honest. Because I oh my gosh, oh my gosh, why is my phone going off? Shut up. Oh. I'm so tired of my phone going off. But there's just a lot going on in my life, and it's hard to be in a dressage club that is always doing something and that you have to meet requirements for, and to be involved in staff and to be involved in commander training and to be involved in their comp team when there's a competition going on. It's just a lot. And this summer was just a lot more on the club than I think anybody thought it was going to be. And so we'll see what it goes from here. I really like making the videos. It's been really fun making the videos. I've made a lot of friends in the dressage world also. So it's been really great to do videos and work with people and all that jazz. There's just gonna have to be some decisions that are made in a couple of weeks. And see how things go. Right now, things seem kosher and I'm feeling pretty good. I'm getting my stuff done. I'm caught up on my stuff. I'm doing pretty well in my class. My roomies and me are talking. I have all my stuff in my room. I need one more textbook, I think. Like, everything's going pretty dang good. I also have recently had some health struggles. I have this, chronic. It's not really like a UTI, but it's like a feeling of a UTI, like this chronic pain in my urinary, like gallbladder or something, and they're trying to figure it out. I've been on a medication for like a month, which kind of sucks. I had to go to the dentist, and now I have to go back to the dentist because the dentist did a sucky job and has to fix it. So yeah, that's great. I also had to change. This all just very personal, so TMI. If you don't want to hear about my personal health struggles, don't listen to this video. But I had to change my birth control because I was having some issues with it, and I was on that birth control for 3 years. So when I changed my birth control, it made things really hard on my body. And I already have anxiety, and I already have mental health problems. So having things that are frustrating bring immediate tears to my eyes is not something I'm used to. And it's really bothersome. So yeah, that also happened. We've been having some finance troubles, me and my boyfriend. Some things happened with his schooling that we weren't expecting to happen. Some things happened with my schooling that we weren't expecting to happen. And then also for me to be able to complete this online class, I was working basically full time, and I had to not be able to work full time And it's just been a lot. It's been a whirlwind. It has been the worst, probably, month of my life, I'll be honest. Like, that's like very over the top and over dramatic, but it just in the moment, it feels like things, like, it's just one thing after another. And it's hard for me to take things in stride when they keep just piling up on each other. And I love every opportunity that I've ever gotten from anything that I've ever gotten, but I've also had to realize that I have to be kind of selfish and take some time for me and love myself and take care of myself. And I wasn't able to take care of myself for a couple of weeks because I was so focused on making everybody else happy. And it didn't really work out for my in real life, for my gaming life, for anybody. So it worked out for you, didn't it, little baby? He's giving me kisses. So it's just been a really hard time for me, and I don't really know what's gonna happen in the future. I know that I'm gonna go to school. I know I'm going to survive. I know I'm gonna have an amazing boyfriend, my two amazing cats. I'm going to do what I need to do. I don't really know what that means for SSO. I'm gonna try to make videos, but if I don't have the time, I don't have the time. So that's just gonna have to be kind of what it is. I'm gonna try to make PQL requirements, the 3 practices a week after my extended leave. I'm hoping that after August, like late August, I'll have a handle on things and like my schedule, and like I'll have the syllabus, so I'll know like when things are due, and I'll be able to map out everything. But law school's law school, so. And apparently my law school really wants to make life hard on me, so they're already talking about pre-course assignments. So some things that some law schools or some graduate schools do is when they give out the syllabus, like give out the syllabus, not even like first class. This is like before your first class, they give you the syllabus and there's pre-class assignments on it. So you have to complete those pre-class assignments before you get to your first class. So even before you've actually gotten into your first class, you have stuff to do. For this online class, I actually have a final exam, which I'm not very excited to do, to be honest. I will say that I really like doing all of the cases, and I really like understanding the law and learning about the law has been a lot of fun for me. It's just this added stress of doing it all with everything else that's been going on in my life. It's hard to find a balance. And it's hard to find a balance when you don't really have your own space and you're not really doing your own thing and you have to answer to other people and you have to do things for other people and you're living with other people and it's just really difficult and I don't have my own space and I'm about to get my own space back and set up my space the way that I like and have my area and have my cat and just be able to do me. So I'm excited about that. COVID is starting to freak me out again. It seems like it's starting to come back. Some schools are requiring the shot. I haven't gotten the shot for specific reasons. Besides me not liking that it's not been tested on too much and hearing terrifying stories, I also have a needle phobia and don't like to put myself through the stress of needles if I don't have to. Also, I am very tiny and I haven't had a good time because it's gonna hit me. Like, if I get the shot, it's gonna hit me a lot worse than it would hit somebody else because I'm so small. It would make me, like, everybody has like adverse effects afterwards, like they get like sick or they don't feel good for like a few days. I have not had a good time to go and get that done because I don't have time to be able to sit at home and do nothing. I have to work, I have to go do stuff, I have things that I gotta do. So it's just been really interesting to me to know that COVID's now coming back. There's also been like myths about it, some things that are true, some things that aren't true. So I just haven't even had time to sit down and do the research on it. If you guys don't agree with me, you guys don't have to agree with me about getting the shot, but right now, until I know that things are going to shut down again, until it's required for my school, I don't feel the need to get the shot. I already have fertility issues. I've heard some fertility issues coming out of the shot. I don't know if that's real. Haven't done the research for it, but there's also been some things coming out about how COVID even was made and how COVID was even presented that make me really nervous about some things that are happening in our country. Well, the country that I live in. So it's just been a time, and I'm just ready to have my own space and worry about myself. So, I'm also really, really ready to have my own apartment for the first time. I mean, like, I lived in a sorority house and I had like my own room and my own bathroom, so I guess kind of like the same thing, because I'm living with other people. But like, these girls are also gonna be law students, so I feel like this sounds terrible and I don't mean it this way, but like, they're gonna be on the same like level as me, as in like, not like, but like, they'll understand. Does that make sense? Like, when people are in different majors than you, they don't always understand like what type of work you're going through or what type of classes that you're taking, and they will, and they're also going to be taking the same exact classes as me because first years all take the same exact classes, first and second semester, so they're picked for you. So I'm just really excited. I'm have to pay for a $215 new windshield and my car to get inspected because my car is up for inspection and there's a huge crack at the bottom of my windshield that goes all the way across. That's been like that for like 2 years, but I had to get it fixed before I get it inspected. So there's just like a lot going on. I had to get my immunization records and send them to my school. I have to do a whole bunch of different things. It's just been a lot, and I'm not really liking how much it's been on me in the last few days. That's one of the reasons why I'm going on student leave so early, so I can figure my life out. It's been really nice to be able to just sit and get my work done, but I also need to be able to get up and get my other work done. So it's just been a really interesting, hard time. So, oh come on, that should have went. I hate when this game does that. Go, legend, go. Okay. There's just been a lot going on. And you know, I'm actually really good. I'll say this. I'm actually a really good time manager when I have a schedule, when I'm living by myself and I can actually like map it out. But when I don't know what's gonna happen on a day-to-day basis and I have like a list like 50 items long to get done, it's just really hard. So, and like when I was working 9 hours out of the day, like I would be gone for most of the day, then I would be tired because I would be on my feet all day. It's just a lot. It's been a lot, and I lost kind of like my support system there for a while, like PQL, I lost it for a second, and then that was really hard. And then everybody was like, "Oh my gosh, we thought we wanted you to leave," and I was like, "I didn't want to leave, but I felt like that was the only option." And like, I didn't really handle things well. But I also didn't really know how else to handle them because it felt like, just in general, like in my life, people weren't very accepting that I couldn't put them first. So it was really hard. Like when I like couldn't tell my like when I had to tell my parents I couldn't come over every single day because I'm like basically living at Nathan's because his parents have my cat because my parents won't let my cat stay at my house because they don't want a cat at their house. It's been like hard because they like want to see me, but I also have like responsibilities. So I've also had to be like, "Hey, like I can come over, but I can't stay the night," or "I can do this, but I can't do this." And like having people disappointed in you like really sucks, but I'm not going to be able to make everybody happy, and yeah, it's just been really difficult. But on a brighter note, I'm have my room stuff all done. It was really fun to go shopping for my room, although I spent too much money. It's been really fun to learn the law and like learn about intentional torts and battery and assault. Like, you know what those things are, but you don't really know like what they entail if you've never really looked into them. And so like that's been really fun. I think next, like, I think I have a test on assault tomorrow or whatever. I just did my first essay on the Iraq style, which I already knew how to do, which would, like, really helped me. It's just like, you know, things are going well, and I'm happy that things are going well. So, yeah. Oh, I really don't like that you're gonna be in my clip. Can you get out of my clip? Thank you. So, yeah, guys. It's just been a time. It's been a time, and I'm so excited for fall. I'm so excited for my life to get started up again. I'm excited to not be in this weird limbo where I'm like, working all day and like have like the same day-to-day life. If you've ever seen that scene in like SpongeBob or Squidward, like moves in like where all the other squids live, and they like just all like do the same thing from day to day to day to day, and it drives them crazy. Like that's kind of how I've been. So yeah, and I'm less stressed, and like it doesn't seem like it, but I am. I'm like so much better than I was, and everything's going really good. So, yeah, watching me take my clip. So yeah, it was great to have you guys come and watch my video again, lovelies. I'm probably gonna make a new one soon. I just have a lot going on, so just bear with me. If you guys want more videos, if you guys want like what I like do to prepare for law school, like all of that, I'm also thinking about making like a day in the life videos for law school. So yeah, we'll see how that goes. I've been thinking about doing it on my phone, but I have a sucky phone, so we'll see what happens. Bye, loves.